And if you look at Ephesians 5, verse 4a, it says, don't use dirty or foolish or filthy words. Don't use dirty, foolish, or filthy words. Because if you use, they become like a mini god for you. Words are powerful tools. If used properly, produces good results. But if used wrongly, can destroy one's life. So that must tell us that when we want to talk, we must be careful. Let us hear what the psalmist says when he was talking about words. In the book of Psalm 34, 12 to 14, Psalm 34, 12 to 14, he said, do you want a long, good life? Okay, maybe I should start from the screen. He said, what man is he that desireth life? It's a question. And loveth many days, that he may see good. That's a question. Who wants to see, who wants life, or who loves life? Yeah, you want love life. Let me see your hand up. Oh, praise the Lord. And then you want to see long life. You don't just love it, but you want to live long. Let me see your hand up. Praise the Lord. As you are raising up your hand, God will grant you the desires of your heart.
Amen.
You will live long in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He did not stop there, but he says, want to see many good things. Then, what should we do? 14, I mean 13. He said what? Read for me. Do what? And then what? Keep your tongue from evil and the lips from speaking God. You know, I told us that scripture said, somebody said, life can be very simple if we know what to do. And scripture does not leave us in darkness. Scripture opens our eyes to know how to live good lives and enjoy good life. And it says, if you want to live good life and long life and see many good days, you must be careful how you talk. In other words, your mouth should not be your God. Your mouth should not control your life. You must ask yourself every moment, this thing I want to say, should I say it or not? Because if you fail to follow scripture, you might not get the desired result. I pray that God will help us to guide what comes out of our mouth in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Your mouth can be your God if it is not properly tamed. And today, there are many slangs, there are many filthy talk around us, to the intent that even Christians speak like the people of the world. There is no difference between a Christian and the people of the world. Let us take it. I pray the Lord help us. I say, I pray the Lord help us.
Amen.
I pray the Lord help us.
Amen.
Number six. Immoral lifestyle. Immoral lifestyle has become the god of many people. The idol they worship, to the intent that whatever immoral lifestyle they have chosen controls them. And I will give you some examples. The first one I have here is drunkenness. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, before I mention the subject of drunkenness, I hope we know that the Baptist denomination is more than 150 years old in Nigeria. Are we aware of that?
Yes.
And you see, each time we gather as pastors, especially the last minister's conference that was held, there was this challenge on pastors. And the challenge is, may this work not die in our hands. May this work not die in our hands. Are we going to allow the numerous infiltration we have around us to kill this work in our hands? In the last minister's conference, one of the preachers said that those founding fathers did their best and they deputed work into our hands. We must not fail. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jefferson Bowen was one of the people that came first. And he did his work. There may not be great results, but today, we are all the result of the work that somebody did. But the question is, in our own hands, will this work not die? Help me ask your neighbor, will this work not die? Ask me well. They will challenge me as pastors, as a pastor, then I will also come back and do what? Answer me now. Challenge members. Pastor will be challenged. Then when Pastor God will also challenge members. Will this work not die in our hands? What we stand for as a denomination, we need to fizzle away in our own time. If the world can survive more than 150 years, it is not in our own hand that it will die. In the next 100 years, maybe many of us will no longer be here, but the world should not die. It should be strong. We must take note of these things. We must be serious with them. We must not say it's not modern. It doesn't look modern. It's not the thing that is in book. People are no longer laying emphasis on this thing. Because they're important. So drunkenness is one of those things we have in our covenant, Baptist covenant. Maybe one of these days I will preach on the Baptist covenant alone. But drunkenness is one of the things there. I will not drink. I will not sip. I will not use to answer me. Entertain. Unfortunately, among us, there are people that are drinking. Have you? Huh? Maybe one bottle of starch. Not too much. Maybe I just take one bottle of starch. One bottle of starch and alcohol. Even one glass of starch. If I take one shot of starch and I move close to you, I'm talking, and you perceive the odor of starch in my mouth, will you take me serious? You say, Pastor, you know. Don't mind Pastor. All these things there is because he has taken something. Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, we read the later part of it, verse 18. He says, don't destroy yourself by getting drunk. In other words, when you drink, you are destroying yourself. So don't destroy yourself by getting drunk. But what do you do instead? He said, but let the Spirit of God fill you. In other words, instead of drinking alcohol, fill yourself with the Holy Spirit. And the moment the Holy Spirit takes over your life, you are more than a drunkard. Because the Holy Spirit intoxicates. But the good thing about the intoxication of the Holy Spirit is it directs you to the right path. Whereas the intoxication of beer will direct you to destruction. May we not be destroyed.
Amen.
I say may we not be destroyed.
Amen.
So whether you drink small or you drink big, you are drunk. And you are worshiping him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Or you don't drink, but you use it to entertain. You also an idol worshiper. Because even though you claim not to drink, but you are giving it to somebody who will be destroyed. And say, man, drink and destroy yourself. Instead of you to be a soul winner, you are a soul destroyer. May that not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number two example is what I call gluttony. Gluttony is also an immoral lifestyle. Food is controlling the life of that individual. He doesn't joke with food. Anything food. Somebody can decide, I want to fast today. If good food passes the front of that person, okay, I'll fast tomorrow. Praise the Lord. We did retreat yesterday. Where we did retreat is where the aroma there will be here. Ah, this place don't be at all. You declare fasting here, you take the grace of God as a living. Praise the Lord. So, gluttony can be an idol to some people. Or food. They don't joke with food. They can't see food and remove their face. And in the name of food, some people can lie. Have you eaten? No. Never eaten. And he has eaten. It's because the food must not pass back. So I must just take this one. Some people have been killed because of food. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When people know that you love food too much, be careful. You might die prematurely. The Lord help us. Bible says, food for the belly, belly for the food. One day everything we want is gone. One day everything. So we shouldn't love food to the extent that when we say, let us fast. Because I can't fast. And I'm not talking about the elderly ones. I'm talking about young people. Young people. Say, I can't fast. I saw one young person, he said, he can't fast. He said, no, I said, yes. I said, my God. I said, you must fast. He said, when I fast, my body will be shaped. Food is becoming the God of darkness. Another example of immoral lifestyle is sexual immorality. And this one we can talk on it, talk and talk and talk and talk over and over again. Some people are married, but any other thing is kept. They will worship you. It's a spirit, it's not ordinary. The spirit that will not allow you to see your wife at home, but when you go outside, you see other women. It's a spirit. It is no good. That idol must be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is that same spirit that makes some people marry two wives, three wives, four wives. Wait a minute. It's an idol. You must not promote it. So let me tell you, everyone, beware. Tell them well.
Beware.
What about among the young people? Let's leave married people. Some people are not married, but they can't stay a week without having sex. In fact, some people have graduated every day. Say, I can't survive. Something is wrong. It's a serious idol. Which means every morning the person must bow down. The person is not married. In most of our higher institutions today, this evil is being practiced among young people. Because it's becoming so common that people are not seeing it as anything bad again. Everybody is doing it. Let's just do it. What do they do? A boy and a girl will be sleeping together and they are telling themselves there's no serious business. They are just having fun. Which fun? You are killing yourself and you are saying you are having fun. The Lord will deliver us. The final example is smoking. You know that some people don't joke with smoke and even cigarettes. Well, I don't know. When I was in secondary school, we had one man that was teaching us mental work. The man, any time of the day you see the man, is many cigarettes. Every time, cigarette is many all over him. Any time of the day. Whether in the morning or in the night, too. Anytime, because the man is a chain smoker. So everything about him has become secret. If he marks your book, you give him book to man. By the time you are collecting the book back, secret is already smelling on you. I'm not exaggerating, I'm telling the truth. Praise the Lord. But I hope that among us today, we don't have smokers. We don't have people who smoke. If you are smoking, you are worshipping an idol. Cut off that cigarette from your life. And the Lord will deliver you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The people who produce the cigarettes, we are so kind enough to inform us that what? Smokers are liable to die young. Well, unfortunately, even medical doctor will smoke. That's what you know that it's not that. Medical doctor will smoke. And his one way is saying that this thing will destroy you. He said, well, some people will actually kill a man before. But was it the secret that will kill him? To run away from the secret. Because smokers are likely to die. Please, young people in the house, I beg you. Run away from cigarettes. Not only cigarettes now, there are some drugs. There's one they call codeine. Tramadol. Hey, that's one I wanted to read. Tramadol. Which other one? Babadu. Praise the Lord. Now, the truth of the matter is we must be very careful because all these things are real. For instance, I got the information that it doesn't take long before they initiate you. Somebody can just be holding lacacera, just ordinary lacacera. But make I see small now. Don't steal anything from anybody. If you want to buy lacacera, go and buy one. And if you don't have money to buy lacacera, stay like that. We just talk about glutoni. If there's no money to buy lacacera, go for water and drink. How can you share lacacera with somebody and you don't know what you are sharing? And the moment you taste it once, before you know what is happening, you begin to look for it. One of the most deadly things that a man can expose himself to is drug. fact, a man who is a drug addict does not mind to sell all his property and get drugs. He will sell everything. If after selling everything, he will tell you that there is this option I expect you. Okay, I promise you. You will take it, just give it. May the Lord deliver us.
Amen.
May the Lord deliver us.
Amen.
All these idols will not help us. We must run away from them. As I conclude, it is pertinent to take note of what the scripture is saying. Because if you look at verse 6 of Ephesians chapter 5, it says, don't let anyone trick you with foolish talk. Don't let anyone trick you. In other words, don't be cajoled. There are many cajoling in our society today. Don't be cajoled. Even at times, some people can use the word of God to trick you. That all these things does not matter. The Bible says, don't let anyone trick you with foolish talk. Why? God punishes everyone who disobeys him. God punishes everyone who disobeys him. And it is not stopped there. And say foolish things. I hope you saw it in your scripture. Huh? Are you seeing it? This one is not. Contemporary English version is what I'm using, if you don't have it. So he says, don't let anyone disobey God. Don't let anyone trick you with foolish talk. God will punish everyone who disobeys him and say foolish things. So, verse 7, don't have anything to do with anyone like that. Run away from anyone who will trick you. Anyone who will not tell you the truth, run away. Anyone who will tell you you are okay the way you are living your life, don't worry. God is not a wicked God. Run away from him because he's tricking you. God will punish anyone who disobeys him. It is my prayer that none of us will be punished in the name of Jesus. None of us will be punished in the name of Jesus. As we live our life this year, let's take note of what God is saying. Practice what God is saying. And God will bless every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say we'll bless every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we continue in the course of the year, the Lord will be opening our eyes to reward. All the while we'll be talking about this don't do, this don't do, this don't do. We've not mentioned reward. The reward is there. And God is going to reward everyone. Of course, you must know that when scripture says God will punish everyone who disobeys, the same scripture will say God will reward everyone who will be. Every act of obedience will be rewarded in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As you seek to obey God, the Lord himself will reward you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we want to thank you this morning. We appreciate you for your word you sent to us. The grace to be doers of your word. Give unto us in the name of Jesus. These words will not stand against us. We will do the right thing all the time. And we will live the kind of life you want us to live. Thank you, my Father. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.